one of the exciting leaps forward in science and medicine is almost a widespread acceptance that this is a integrated system. So when I trained as a physician, the prevailing view was that each system operated independently. So everybody was an ologist. You were a cardiologist or a gastroenterologist or a psychologist. And the different disciplines, you know, had their own journals, their own language. It didn't really speak to each other. Not only was there a lot of research coming out originally in the 70s and the 80s and the 90s, starting to disprove that whole kind of philosophy. The interdisciplinary nature of the sort of mind-body connection is widely accepted now. And the debate has moved on to, well, how does it really work as an integrated unit? One of the things that's fascinated me for the last 25 years is the quality of communication between different bodily systems and how critical that is to the functioning of the whole. It has a very profound impact on health and well-being and has really important implications for psychotherapy, for medicine, and for humanity at large. If you look at how our identity is constructed, a lot of information comes from our body into our mind, into various centers of the lower part of the brain, where we get a sort of what's called a first order construction of self, or the identity of the I. We sort of shape a sense of who we are. And then we layer over in the sort of hierarchical neural network, we layer over more information and get a second order representation of self. So really that thing that we know as I is an artificial construction. There's no concrete substance to it. And so therefore, if it's constructed, it can be deconstructed and reconstructed in a different way.